Hey, what's up you guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Abhinav Bengala and I'm back with a new video. Most of you guys were asking about make a video on JEE mains and NEET exams that are coming in the next month, September. So I'm going to discuss about these examinations. Not only these examinations, also some of the states and some of the universities are also released the schedules for the final year semester examinations and PG examinations in different states in the September month. But most of the people are asking to postpone the examination. Let's discuss about this topic in this video. So let's get started. In this situation, students have to decide between their exams, lives, and their career, what is important for them. But most of the people may be telling that lives are more important than other two. But our government is considering to conduct examinations in the month of September. JEE, that is the joint entrance examinations conducted every year for the students who have passed out in their intermediate and take admissions in the engineering colleges like IITs, NITs, etc. This year, around 11 lakh students have applied for the JEE examinations, and the government has scheduled these examinations from 1st September to 6th September. Also, NEET examinations that are conducted for the medical students, around 17 lakh students have applied for this examination, and this examination is scheduled on 13th of September. So some of the parent associations and some of the student unions have filed a appeal on this examination to either postpone or cancel these examinations on the highest court of India, which is the Supreme Court. Supreme Court has also given the judgment via a video conferencing that these exams can be conducted for JEE mains and NEET exams. So the actual question comes is why the exams have to be postponed. Now I'm going to give you the reasons. First reason is India is the third most worst affected country in the world behind US and Brazil. So it is inevitable that if the students just come together and write the examination in their single exam centers, the probability of spreading of this virus is more. Some of you might argue that students are not muchly affected by this virus, but in India we can see a lot of joint families. But if a student is got affected by the COVID, then after he reaches his home, there are chances that his family members like his grandparents may get affected, and this is not good for the family. Also, the students who have attended the examinations may also move around the place as asymptomatic carriers in their college or while they transport from their house to the college center. In this situation, most of the parents are not willing to send their children for the examinations because they are not ready to risk the lives of their children for the sake of the examinations. Also, there are some parents who have no other option instead of sending them to the examinations due to the financial problems in their family. So they are sending their children forcefully to write these examinations. Government is saying that they are following the SOPs at the examination centers. You can see in the past few weeks, there were examinations conducted in Karnataka named COMDEC, and team examination was conducted in Kerala, and the UGEE examination was conducted in UP. But in these three examinations, you can clearly see how much crowd has been found by the students in the examination centers. They are not properly maintaining the social distance in between them, and SOPs are not followed in this situation. The next reason may be due to this rainy season, most of the areas are being getting flooded and landslides have been happening. So there is a problem of transportation also. And how can the government say that the students present there can be able to prepare for the examination and go and write the examinations? Most of these students are tensed about their transportation also. In most of the states now, still transportation is not yet fully started. No trains, no buses, no metro rides, everything is stopped now. And how can the government expect the students to go to the exam center without their proper public transport facility in their states? UGC has ordered the states to conduct all the final year examinations and also the JEE mains, NEET, and all the examinations that were pending before 30th of September. But some states are facing difficulty in doing so because every state has their own problems in this pandemic. So all the states cannot conduct examinations at the same time. Like if you take the example of US and Germany, in those countries, they have divided the authority to decide whether the exam should be conducted now or later according to the region wise or state wise, so that all the problems of the state and region are covered. Now most of you guys were thinking what may be this solution for this problem. This is a very tough decision that is to be taken by the Supreme Court and the central government. Supreme Court have already told its verdict to conduct the examinations in the month of September, but the decision is still pending in the hands of the central government. I think the government should have listened to the students' problems and students' issues, what are the problems that these students are facing, and then give a proper solution to this, and then should have conducted the examinations in the month of September but the government has not done so. They could also conduct the examinations later after this COVID pandemic situation comes under control, not totally vanished, but at least comes under control in this country. So students, this video is made to showcase the problems that you are facing in writing these examinations in the COVID period. So hit that like button and share this video as much as possible so that this video goes trending and most of your problems are solved as soon as possible by the government. Make sure to hit the subscribe button for more videos like this on my YouTube channel. That's it from me today. See you next time.